feel out of this world. I gotta love you. I gotta love you. I'm gonna love you, baby, 'cause you know I'm a fool about you. I wanna love you nice and kind. I can't get you off of my mind. I wanna love you. I gotta love you.
Come on right now.
Yeah.
Come on again.
We have the privilege and the great honor to have here at our humble studios, TEDER FM studios in Tel Aviv, Israel, Mr. L.C. Ulmer. How are you, sir?
Fine. How are you doing?
I'm great. You know, I'm very excited to have you here. So we are trying to figure it out technically, but I think we're all sorted in a way.
Well, I'm a pleasure to be here. I'm happy to be around men who love music.
Thank you so much. That's who we are. We're all about music, and the reason we are so excited is because we have you, obviously, around here in the studios. And you just arrived to Israel, right?
Yeah, I'm so proud to be in your studio tonight.
Ah, thank you, thank you. And when did you arrive here?
Yesterday. I just arrived here yesterday.
Nice one. And how do you like it so far?
Well, I tell you, but you ain't never been to a place before, and time you see it, you like it, right. So there ain't nothing else to say. But I'm meeting all good people, you know?
That's good. That's the most important thing, no?
And, I'm meeting people who are really in life loving music. And that's the life, the way my Bible teaches me about music all the time.
Right.
Music is one of the things that soothes the Susan B. Because I know, because I played for a bear and he wouldn't even bother me.
Right.
I know all this. And I played for snakes that come out of the barrel and they wouldn't even bite me. I played for frogs, dogs, hogs, chicken. When I was learning.
That was the audience,
I'd go down in the woods and sit up on a stump. Ooh. And play my guitar. Everything in them woods would come up there. Horses, cows, pigs, or snakes. They come well. I didn't bother none of them. The honeybees would light all over me. They love music. Okay. The yellow jackets, they wouldn't sting me. I'd sit there and play. And when I meet people, as I meet the creature that God made on earth that love music, I know then there's a big bunch of people that love music, so I'll come into that today over here in Europe. And I'm mighty proud to be here and to be in your presence.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It's our, as I said, it's our privilege, and that's why I'm so excited. I'm sure you can hear and feel it about me.
Yeah.
And this is a great opportunity for us. As you know, Israel is very far away from the U.S. never alone the whole story and the continent of America. We are for us it's all stories, but I guess when you are here you can tell the real thing.
I'm gonna improvise them for you.
Right.
Back in the music days.
Exactly.
When I was coming along back in the music time, from 9 and a half years old, I was beating on a guitar.
You just got it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a whooping about it. Back in the day, your daddy didn't allow you to use his music. But I'd steal it and put it back like it was up there. I thought I did. But he knew, your parents knew something was wrong. And he whooped me about it. So I got big enough to ask him to let me work with him to buy me my own guitar. And after I bought my own guitar, then I commenced learning.
To learn how,
I learned,
how to use it.
Then I commenced learning. Come on up to 1937. I was listening to Blind Boy Phillip, Blind Lemon Jefferson.
Wow.
And the girl put out that song about St. Louis women wears a diamond ring, lead the men around by the apron string. What you lay for this?
No, that's you.
Now this is back there.
No.
This here is in 35.
That's what I'm laughing about because I'm overwhelmed because you know you try to say the name of the song but you just sang it. So you know it's for me it's the best.
She was one of our greatest singers. I just can't call her name. I had called it once this evening. I've been had so many people around me this evening. I'll be forgetting things looking at women. I better stop that too.
If you haven't done it till now, it's all good. You can keep on doing it. You just can keep on.
Yeah, well, I have to keep on doing that. But anyway, there come me. I'm on Mark Blind Bar Phillip.
Hmm. Okay. I didn't know that.
Yeah. Blind Bar Phillip.
Hmm.
Yeah, he put out that record about, hey, mama. Hey, gal. Don't you hear me calling you? You so sweet. Hey, sweet. My little woman so sweet. I love my baby. Love her to a bone. Hate to see my sweet sugar go home. She's so sweet. Hey, sweet. My little woman so sweet. See my baby coming. Don't get so smart. I'll cut your liver. I will hug your heart. She's so sweet, hey, sweet. My little woman, so sweet. See, I learned these things back in the 30s.
Right.
I ain't forgot them.
Just a second. I want to cheer you up for that verse. It's not something that we used to, you know. But anyway, go ahead. Sorry.
And Peter Whipstraw, the devil's son-in-law.
Yes.
You ever hear about him?
You know what? No.
All right, I'm going well on back there.
Yeah, yeah. So,
this is what they want to hear now when you go out to play music. They want to know these old
the
songs.
Roots, the roots
yeah,
the, of the
now
music.
Now you're talking.
Yeah.
I'm glad you brought that out. Appreciate that. He put out about, when you dig my grave, please let me down with a silver spade. I ain't gonna be no stranger. You can have a silver chain too. But when I pass on, you'll know just what to do. I said, lady, you called me to be dead. I love you to my bone, but you broke up my home. Whenever I pass on, and you dig my grave with a silver spade, let me down with a silver chain. I ought to quit that. Now, that's way back.
Woo!
You see, ain't nobody...
It is way back, though.
Yeah, ain't nobody got that on the record today.
Unfortunately, for me, as you know, as a lover of this soulful, gospel, bluesy music, which comes from the heart, I'm missing that, you know?
Yeah. Now, when I was coming up, and after I got out in the cotton field, you know what them
yeah,
is.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, then I went to singing my own self.
Your own tunes.
Yep, I went to singing my own self. Hey, little girl, I see you walking. You sure do worry me. I ain't gonna tell you how much, cause it may put you to a third degree.
What's
you laughing at?
No, that's what I'm saying. That's it.
All right. You called me in here, so that's what you called me in here for.
Exactly.
All right. I'm going on. I'm going to tell you. You need to be so flirty, and you need to be so fly. There's other girls standing waiting on some guy. I may be the one. Walk away from you, baby. Find nothing to carry on. Hey, the blue will get you. They will get you just for breakfast. You have to walk away from your table. Not no poor food in your mouth. Why are you gonna do that? Oh, baby. Thinking about you. You made me overfeel. I don't have to eat, girl. Long I'm thinking about a pretty girl like you. You got my world. You got it all sold up.
Yeah!
I want to thank you again from the bottom of my heart to be here, and this is the reason, I guess, why we're so excited to have you do this for us. You know, our own studio, it's like a small bedroom where you sing your heart out to us. And this is really overwhelming for us. And thanks, Yamit, for making this happen. By the way, she's out here over somewhere. And
she's out there. she's listening.
She's listening. And the thing is, which I guess people told you already, but this broadcast is, you know, streamed live via the internet, online. And
here it is.
Hmm?
Yeah.
Sorry?
That's where I'm at.
Yeah?
What's your mouth? Where you put me? You put me in jeopardy.
No, come on. No. Just the opposite of that.
Well, I tell you, I'm so overwhelmed to be here. I just don't know what else to say. But I'm going to sing you this song.
All right. Go ahead.
Well, you know, there's it one right there. Hey, baby. Don't you want a man like me?
But of course.
I go to work 365 days in the year just to feed poor you. You don't have to beg nobody else to buy you a brand new shoe. I'm gonna dress you. I'm gonna take it downtown. Take it in the high store there. Let you buy what you want. I'm gonna tell the man, don't even look at me till she finish buying. I'll pay for everything she gets. That's gonna be my baby. So I'm trying to make her my little wife. Come on, I'm gonna build a home. I wonder where I'm gonna buy my homeland. Or where will I buy? I'm gonna make her be a lovely, lovely girl in the land.
Yeah.
I'm gonna give her everything she needs. She ain't gonna have to wait for no man, please. She gonna have her money anytime she wanna buy. She gonna have her money to walk out in the street and say, I got a man, I don't need you. Give me everything I need. Hey, baby, hey, right now. Hey, baby, hey, right now. Goodbye, all you men. I don't need your loving at all. I got a man. He give me what I want. He buy me anything. He bought me a Rolls Royce. And I know I love this man. I ain't got the big for a ride. Oh, let me tell you, you ain't got the big for a ride. She says, I'm gonna stay with this man until death call him a mean one. I know I got a wife. I know I got a wife. She called me to live a very good life.
So you're gonna go to an interlude, a track you chose,
the Elvis one,
and then we're gonna breathe a little bit and come back with you,
go
sir.
Ahead. Go out of here.
Yes.
Well, that's all right, Mama. That's all right for you. That's all right, Mama. Just any way you do, that's all right.
FM. צמרמורות באולפן. הבחור שלצידנו, למי שהזין, למי שפה לידינו, מספר לנו שהוא ניגן עם אלוויס. אנחנו נדון איתו על זה רגע. So sir, you just told us when the tune played that you played on this album with Elvis, right?
I played with him out there in Arizona a many times. Oh, this Paul, maybe Ford.
Wow.
Best Domino. Louis Armstrong.
And how was it? How can you tell us a little bit experience about
this? I was a dentist out there in Arizona. and they had a big cock and bull room, big as this place, you know, almost. And I was a dentist, and whenever they come, well, I was playing a one-man band at that time.
Right. It's an opening show.
I was the man that opened up, and yeah. I was the man that cut the music for them to put on the menu, what they're going to put on the menu. And they would play it every morning on the radio.
Right.
Out there every morning. That was back in the 50s. I know that's a long time ago.
Yeah, it is.
I ain't forgot it. They ain't either, because they called me on it the other day. They said, we hear about you still announcing us how you worked out there. I worked out there, you know. And I went down to California.
Okay.
And I got on the train. I ain't never told nobody this. I started at 613 miles from Holbrook to Los Angeles.
Whoa.
I got on the train.
How long it takes? How many days?
Huh?
How many days it takes to do the solo?
No, I had been out that end.
Ah, okay.
I was working there in Arizona. I catch the train every Friday, go to California.
Right.
I go out there to play. And when I got on the train, guess what? They wouldn't let me stop in California. They said I was blowing a harp and playing a guitar then. I went on, I didn't care the whole band with me, I just cared two pieces. So they kept me on to where they turned around at, man, and bring me back and put me off. They said, you blow that harp. I kept people that woke all night on the train, playing the harp, making money all up and down the cars. And when it got daylight, be in California, he said, hey, we ain't gonna put you off now. All them polters. Man, so you kept this thing hot last night. Said, so we're going to carry you to where we turn around, bring it back, and ain't going to cough you nothing. I was getting bought without paying anything, but I was going down the road. Now, I'm going to sing some song that I was playing back in them days.
Go ahead. Give us one, please, sir.
There's a reason. That's why I can't get a girl. I've been drinking all my life, throwing my money away. Don't no good, want no man. Broke every day, better watch out, boys. I'm telling you the truth. No woman, no want no man. Stay broke every day. Cause she can't buy nothing. And he can't buy nothing for. He don't have the money. She gonna get a man that do. That's gonna make you lose her. All over the world that happens. You better watch me. I'm gonna start drinking. I'm gonna get a girl that understand. And I'm gonna be her great loving man. I'm moving out of this place, baby. I mean this old trash in my heart. Gonna clean it up, and I'm gonna act smart. I'm gonna keep my dough from now on. So when I meet a girl, she needs something, I can buy it and take it to her home. Do you understand me? You understand what I mean? I lost too many girls. I tried to buy a home. I was drinking so I couldn't even make a home. Nah, I changed my mind. Since the change my mind, I got a new home. And the women's falling for me like leaves falling off a tree. Lord, I got something going on. I got something going on. Baby, don't you want a man like me? Want a man like me? Oh, baby, you want a man like me. Woo! I love you, baby. I love you, she's a bone. I hate to see my sweet sugar go home. I'm gonna buy a home and ask your mom and dad, may I get this girl for my own? If he said yes, baby, you already got a home. Go to, you don't have to worry no more.
Now ask the man,
I got my own home.
Since then?
Yes, sir. Paid for and everything. I don't care why if that not. She ain't got to worry about parking the car.
Nothing.
She can park, I can park 2,000 cars in front of my door any day.
Let's listen to another one.
Yeah.
From this.
Yeah.
Dancing and the tune stopped. Maybe you put us another and you play us another song.
The Albert King one.
Yeah, the Albert King tune what you chose for us, and we can just say he over here.
Ladies,
thanks again for coming over, TEDER FM. This is yeah. Listening to a cover of Blind Lemon Jefferson made by Albert King, Matchbox. So, Justin, you want to say something? Do something? No. Anyway, I've been told that your favorite guitar player ever was Blind Lemon Jefferson. Is it correct?
That's right.
can you tell us why?
That's right.
And can you tell us why?
Yeah, I can tell you why. Because him and my daddy played together for years.
All right.
Way before I was born. See, he's old on the job.
So
he went. You know, he the one went to Russia.
Mm.
Way back. Russia put him up to be one of the worst guitar players in that time anywhere in the world.
The 20s, yeah?
Yeah. Mm. He was one of the worst guitar players. Well, and by my brother buying his records, well, I learned how to play his tune.
So we can say that he's one of your biggest inspirations?
Yeah, he's one of my biggest inspirations.
Mm.
And when I went over to Switzerland, I got a chance to see all his pictures and hear all his records again.
In Switzerland?
Yeah, I went to Switzerland and Italy.
Yeah, I understand, but how come in Switzerland they have all this documentation?
They got everybody's record that ever been made, the first record from the first year.
Right.
They started to cut records on the wall.
Mm.
And you go there, you can see, and they got the pictures with them.
Wow.
All up in their music store over there.
Right.
That's how.
And they still keep on reissuing these
records? Yeah, they keep on reissuing. You see, music don't die.
Never. I agree.
If you can keep it alive, it's gold. All the musicians I reckon that ever played, they can't tell you who the blues sang in the bow.
No, I totally...
You ain't never heard that?
I hear you. I totally hear you.
I know who it was and can tell you who it was, can tell you what he was doing.
Go ahead, sir.
All right. The man was named Elijah. He was a prophet, right?
Mm.
Big prophet. Head prophet of God.
Yeah, big prophet of God.
All right. Here it come. It was another man in the field plying 12 yokes oxen. Here you lay. He was a young lad.
Mm.
And he had the blues. He was singing the blues in the field plying 12 yokes oxen. Well, Elijah went by. He wanted what Elijah had. He followed him for a ways and told him, to look, let me go back and kill 2 yoke oxen, feed my people, and I'll come back. He did. Followed Elijah to that mount. You know him, right?
Mm-hmm.
Who did Elijah throw that mantling back to when he left whole soul and body?
Who was he?
The man who sang in the blues, Elisha.
Mm.
It's in your Bible. And that made him become the top prophet, the blues singer. That's why the blues come out of the field. Well, you ask a lot of blues players that they don't know. Or they'll say it come out of the field, but they don't know who win.
Right.
No, I'm telling you who
uncredited,
win.
Uncredited always. No, not always, but most of the time it's... Never has the credit, never had the source. Where is the source?
Well, people don't have to study and find out. You hear folks say the blues don't need to be sung. They're wrong. Blues is telling you something about the world.
It's a storytelling in a minor...
That's form. Right. It's just keeping you reminding about people who get married and they let something come between them and break them up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do, sir.
Yeah. And that's not the way God wanted it. And... A lot of folks take the blues the wrong way. Now, you hear me sing the blues, but you will never hear me talk about a woman. No, I ain't talking about that now. I'm talking about, we got so many folks scorn women when they're singing.
Right.
They put bad words in the music. You never hear me say that.
Never.
I don't do that. You don't scorn. I'm going to tell you something that you don't know. I done read it in the Bible. This is, the women, they're great. You ought to read about it.
In the Bible?
I done read through the Bible 7 times. I know what I'm talking about. These women are great. And I've been married 3 times. Never fought my wife, never cussed them. If I don't want somebody, turn and walk away.
Mm.
You know, Elvis Presley put out the record about, feel so bad, feel like a ball game on a rainy day. Feel so bad, feel like a ball game on a rail. I got my rain check, I just turn and walk away and walk away and walk away. That's the way you do when you got a girl.
Right.
Somebody else's daughter, because you got a daughter. You're going to have one, and you wouldn't want her mistreated.
No, I do have one.
Well, you don't want her mistreated.
No, I don't want her at
get,
all.
When she get married, you want her to be not beat up.
No, no, treated.
Not,
treated
not cut either. Up.
No, never, never.
All right, then that's what I'm trying to tell you. Women are great.
Right.
Women are great. Folks ought to see what they did in the Bible. I know I done read it. You're great. And I don't get up and sing nasty songs. You go down the street and hear folk got these bumping records, bump, 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 bump. Now, if I was a governor in over some state, no, you wouldn't hear that.
No, no.
You think
no.
I'm joking?
No, 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 no. I totally hear you. That's why I'm just.
Do you know? Do you know where I put him? The guy be doing that in the car, bumping and talking and get all that old nasty talk.
What do you do?
I'd sit to the pen. Without a trial, and set the rest of the pen up on top of him and bill him nothing. Cause you look, man, look, you got women out here. You respect your women, folks.
No, we do here. I can guarantee you that.
Well, that's ah, I like that.
No, seriously, we do. No,
well,
for us, it's well important, very important thing for us.
Sure.
Seriously.
Sure. You respect your women.
No, folks. Isn't it? She's laughing. Am I right? Or?
You're very right. Yeah, all women folks are lovely. You know why?
No.
You never thought. How'd you get here? Huh? How'd you get that fellow? I hear you talking. Well, how'd you get here?
How did I get to the world?
Tell the truth.
To the world? I got through a woman, I think. That's my mom.
All right, then. Tell the truth. I like to hear that.
Yeah. You asked me how I got to the world?
No, that's what the question. How women get to the world.
How women get to the world?
By man.
By man?
And women.
They come by man. But
from the Bible.
But they birthed them. God told her, the serpent will bruise your son, heal, but your son will bruise his head.
Adam and Eve.
All right. Yeah. So the women are great. They are great. And
we know that. We know. We as I said, we appreciate that and totally agree with that. And sorry, go ahead. Sorry.
All right. I'm all saying you know the song.
Go ahead. I know. I probably don't know it, but
I'm all saying a song that. Now you know I'm a guy that sang song that nobody never heard.
That's my you know that's my wish for you.
This is what I used to sing to my girlfriend. She told me when I was in school, we were breaking school up, and I was dancing with the prettiest girl there. And they had a man there playing the guitar. This year's rough, yeah. And he was playing it, and everybody was dancing. Me and her winning the prize. But she told me after that, she said, when you learn how to play a guitar, you can get me back.
So you did.
Wait a minute. I didn't tell her nothing. So I was learning, but she didn't know it. The next year, I played for the school breaking up.
And then you got the gift.
No, wait now, hold it now. This year gonna knock you out too. Here's the way it went. I'm telling you the truth, something that need to be heard. She said, I went on over there and played that night. The school teacher told me, he said, listen, hey, Mr. Ulmer, said, you ready to play for this school breaking up? We didn't tell nobody I could play then. I had to learn for the next school.
Yeah.
I said, yes, ma'am. I'll come out there with the guitar and practice all there. When I broke it up that night, she walked up to me and said, nah, you can get me back. I told her I don't need you.
Woo! Woo! Yeah.
I said, nah, I'm going to get more women than a passenger train can haul. And I'm going to buy me a brand new V8 Ford, and the prettiest woman you ever seen going to be in that Ford right side of me. I went on and bought me two Lincoln Continentals, brand new. And the prettiest woman you ever seen out of Jolly, Illinois, they was in them cars. Then that ain't all. I got me a bunch of go-go girls. You know what them is?
Yeah, we do.
Get on stage, I had them a call. I was making money. So I sung that song about, next time you see me, things won't be the same. Next time you see me, things won't be the same. But if it hurt you, darling, only have yourself to blame. It's all to sin. All that shine and gold. All to sin. All that shine and gold. But if it hurt you, darling, only have yourself to blame. Well, you lied, you cheated, ever so long. Well, you lied, you cheated, ever so long. But if it hurt you, darling, only have yourself to blame. Oh, to sin, all that shine and gold. Oh, to sin, all that shine and gold. But if it hurt you, darling, only have yourself to blame. Next time you see me, another man, another woman be sitting on your throne. Next time you see me, another woman be sitting on your throne. But if it hurt you, darling, only have yourself to blame.
I say, let's listen to this.
Jimmy Rogers, we have like 5 minutes left for this broadcast. I don't know, it's up to you. You run things, so.
Yeah, what do you want? I want to play Jimmy Rogers.
All right. Yeah, let's do that.
Even pals that I know are true. Still I'm lonely, homesick and blue. There's no one who can cheer me when I'm alone, longing for my Mississippi home. Way down in the Delta, on that Mississippi shore, in that muddy water, I long to be once more. When night shadows creep about and the whippoorwills call, you can hear old Mammy shout, come in here, you all. Way down on the levee, strolling in the pale moonlight, you can see those steamboats and the fields of snowy white. There's a feeling I can't lose, that muddy water in my shoes. When I get that Mississippi Delta blue, de-o-de-lee-hee, de-o-de-lee-hee. I long to hear them darkies sing those old melodies, Swanee River and old Black Joe. That sweet magnolia perfume floating on the breeze. Way down south is where I long to go. Way down in the Delta, on that Mississippi shore, in that muddy water, I long to be once more.
In that muddy water.
When night shadows creep about.
TEDER FM, תודה רבה לכל מי שמאזין ולכל מי שפה. אנחנו פה באולפן בהתרגשויות על ומנסים להקל מעבר עלינו, מעבר עלינו. יש פה אדם מדהים, מוזיקאי, גיטריסט, פסנתרן, בלוזיסט, בן 85 בשם אלסי ארמר, שבא להופיע
בסוף שבוע הזה באינטי מדבר במצפה רמון, וכדאי לכולם להיות שם, ואנחנו נגיד לו תודה. Thank you so much, sir, for being with us. This is this has been one of the most exciting things I've done radio wise for sure. And I just want to thank you for coming over all the way to Israel, and especially for this humble small studio, guerrilla studio we are running over here. And for your kind words, for your amazing aura and message for good music, for conscience and quality music, because that's what we're all about, and that's why we are so privileged to have you here.
And I'm so glad to be here.
Thank you so much.
In the presence of the people of Israel.
Thank you.
So glad to be
here.
This
is your first time, right? I didn't even ask you.
This is my first time.
We don't just call it the Holy Land. It has this this feeling. I hope you feel it as well.
I do.
Thank you, sir. So this is, again, thank you, sir. LC Ulmer, you're going to play Friday and Saturday down south at the Negev, at the desert of Israel. I'm sure I'll be there, and I hope everyone will be there. And Monday too in Jaffa, right? In the port of Jaffa, Machzan 2, storage 2, Machzan 2. Anyway, so yeah, let's go hang out outside. I'll put another last track that I chose this time. I told you that I love Screaming Jay Hawkins, and I just wanna play it for you. This is the last track for the show. After us, we have another great show. This is the blues, guys. Thanks for listening to TEDER Tel.